There are several very important skills to have. One of these skills is spiritual literacy. To be spiritually literate is the most important literacy of all, for sure. The second is to spend time sitting quietly, committed to not reacting to anything, not doing anything. So important. Do not be an activist crusader who spends no time downtime. You should, every day you should have downtime as far as trying to fix the world that goes. And where you just say, I'm not going to do anything. Committed to doing nothing whatsoever. This is allows the truth to emerge within you. And then you realize, oh my gosh, I can rapture the entire universe right now, this instant. I can rapture the entire universe this very instant. See, everything turned to light. Everything just simply turned to light. Light bodies, light world, light plants, light. Without another instant taking place, there's no backstory needed whatsoever. So, spiritual literacy is what I worked on my entire life. I'm way more spiritually literate than I am in my own language, English language, using way more. So that was my focus going into this lifetime. Spiritual literacy. Constantly keep yourself, the buzz, spiritual buzz, going. And so you become spiritually literate, which means you're able to relate to what arises as clarification within you. You say, yeah, fits right in. Rapture the entire universe. It's not you that need to be raptured. It's the universe that needs to be raptured. It's not you that needs to ascend. It's the entire universe needs to ascend. All together, one, simultaneously. Uh-oh. I hear the... Uh-oh. You see? And you better do it quickly before all this starts. You know what I'm saying? This is what's coming in the world. Okay. Wow. We can rapture the entire universe. No backstory to I Am is necessary whatsoever. There's zero necessity to any backstory whatsoever. And that is true this instant, right now, there's zero necessity. The entire universe, there's zero necessity for it to be seen as a backstory. Nothing needs to be seen as a backstory. Nothing is bound to any backstory whatsoever. This very instant rapture the entire universe. This is very doable. Very doable. Release. Rapture the universe means release the entire universe. It's free from any necessity to try to weave a backstory to I Am. To weave a past. The story, though, backstory that we're telling ourselves. Because the weed whackers, the activists, the crusaders are coming. The crusaders are coming. We don't understand the mentality that's built up. Or maybe we do understand. Okay, we do understand that the attitudes and the attention, everything that's been built up through popular media, through popular culture, is a crusader mentality. A crusader mentality. They pick their targets. They pick, for instance, the tobacco companies. All right, that's an easy villain to pick. And they sharpen their claws on that. They sharpen their crusader abilities on that. And they've targeted traditional marriage, for instance, and targeted that. They target, you know, the crusaders target different stuff. But what they're doing is they're strengthening their crusaderness, their crusader attitudes. And global crusade is coming. The whole world is going to be a crusader world. And there's no allowance for you sitting quietly doing nothing. Are you doing nothing? No explanation is the best explanation. Liberation is spiritual salvation is not a place. It's not a pill, it's a place. Spiritual salvation is not a pill, it's a place. And what is that place? self-released in the now. All the place of freedom. This place is right here, right now, as the now. Not the Storyland dream. So we can have an attitude of release. Release everyone, without exception, from any necessity on your part to maintain any sort of backstory to I Am-ness. Therefore, you don't need to see them as bodies. You can see them as light. See them as light. See, everything is beautiful, light, free. It's funny thing is that it's light that's telling the backstory of light. Because we asked it to. And now we forget we asked it to. And now we're assuming that light needs a backstory. We look at this world and say, wow, light really needs a backstory, huh? Okay, this is very important. Without a backstory, it wouldn't exist. We're forgetting that we desire to experience this backstory to light. And so light is presenting it to us. It doesn't need a backstory. Light, living light doesn't need any backstory to it. How did it become living light? It is. It's created intrinsically so. So the unrepentant ones are the ones who forget that little detail that we're the ones that asked for this presentation by light. And assuming that no, light did it on its own, thinking that it needs it. That's not true. It's not true. The repentant ones realize deep down, you know what? This is all a sham here. We asked light to do this, to trick us, to deceive us. And so that's putting on this very deceptive play. Very deceptive play. But we ask for that. It's not the fault of light. Light doesn't need it. Okay? There's no necessity to any of this. There's no necessity whatsoever. So just accept and extend this truth. There's no necessity to anything whatsoever. Everything is self-released in the now, and unreleased event is impossible. And now, obviously, it's understandable that the younger people have more energy, they're more active, they tend to be more pulled into crusading, at least on the fringes maybe. But what I'm saying is, make sure that you spend every day some downtime where you're committed to doing absolutely nothing about anything whatsoever. Because then this gradually allows this realization to arise within you, and you won't feel threatened by it. Whereas if you believe your identity is based on being a crusader, you'll feel very threatened by this. You see, so this is why a world that is based on a crusader mentality is very, very troublesome, problematical for realization, release from delusion. It's because you feel that your identity needs this crusade. And if you just do nothing, you feel you're going to lose your identity. So a crusader world basically will eliminate, eradicate downtime, the kind of downtime that you need, the kind of doing, the attitude of nothing needs to happen, nothing needs to be done, everything is already free right now. Everything is intrinsically free. So the crusaders over here, see, they're coming. They're here. This mentality is here. So, don't struggle with it. Don't struggle with it. Don't struggle at all. Don't struggle. But just hear what's being said. Now, is it possible to the problem, you'll be shouted down in the world. Okay. What's coming up now, the Crusaders will shout you down. There's no question about it. The voice of spirit, the quiet voice, will be shouted down by the frantic buzzsaws of the Crusaders. The Crusaders got chainsaws on there. They're looking for trees to cut down. You know, they're fanatics, extremists, actually. And they want to drown the voice of reason out in this world. No question about it. Now, will there be a mass exodus from this planet? I wouldn't be surprised at all. If there is not one, I also would not be surprised. It's tough to handicap this, but either way, I wouldn't be surprised. Let's put it that way. And this is a good attitude to have. Prepare as if it's possible. And if it doesn't happen, you're also prepared if it's not possible, if it doesn't happen. And either way, you're released. Everything is released. Enlightenment is not your enlightenment, per se. It is you releasing the whole universe. The universe does not need to do anything whatsoever the next moment for you to be, feel that you are one with all. You release the entire universe from any belief in process, story, necessity, form, time, space. It's intrinsically free. Give the whole universe its freedom. You don't need it. You don't require it. You see, you realize you don't require it whatsoever. That the oneness is perfectly perfect, all-inclusive, not threatened in the slightest bit. Doesn't need any backstory whatsoever. This is something we can all do. And this morning I was working on this. So all of this, these concepts and this understanding, recognition, it's all very, I said, oh yeah, this sounds familiar to me. Okay, because we've been working on it here. And I saw, oh, it's very possible to do this. Absolutely. And I was attempting to do it. Now, it didn't quite catch fire, but it certainly was attempting to. And so it is absolutely possible. The entire framework is there for us, and the teaching is here for us. But, you know, what will happen with this massive crusader mentality in the world? Whatever it is, you know, you could be the next target of the crusade. You don't know. They've targeted so much stuff already, haven't they? And whoever gets targeted by these crusaders, you know, they collapse, they crumble. It's the modern day crusaders. They're better equipped than any crusade in history. And they live for this, actually. This is their existence. They say something has to change. We have to alter the backstory. The backstory has to be made better. What we're saying is no backstory is needed for anyone, any place, ever. None. There's zero necessity for any backstory. So right now, you may be sick, released as you are. Right now, you may be well, released as you are. Right now you may be very poor, released as you are. You might be very rich, released as you are. You might be a crusader, released as you are. You might be a non-crusader, released as you are. All of the universe released exactly as it is right now. Without anything needing to change in the slightest bit. That's why I say it's released this instant. You can release it this instant. You're not requiring any story at all. So not another instant needs to pass for everything to stand free and clear of any necessity of any backstory ever, and no need to reference any backstory whatsoever. This is not a pipe dream. This is what the teachers are recommending us, and I see it's doable. It is doable. Now, sitting quietly helps a lot, because you don't feel like you need to run out and make something happen or to stop something from happening. Just let the whole story just turn into light, vanish into just the freedom of light. practice just thinking of various people and their where their occupate their station in life. Release them this instant from that. They have no more need for that. Release everyone this instant. They have no more need, from your standpoint, to engage in any backstory whatsoever. They are not trapped in the slightest bit by any story, not by anything in the universe. No one is, from your perspective, no one is trapped at all in the slightest bit. In any circumstances, they are not trapped in circumstances whatsoever. This instant. So give the whole entire universe its freedom, and you will feel your freedom. So, be willing to accept that nobody is trapped in any circumstances whatsoever. No one. Even the one you think is your worst enemy. Say, they too are not trapped in any circumstances. No conceivable circumstances, good or bad, is anyone ever trapped in the slightest bit. We're spirit. We're not trapped in any circumstances. No such thing. There's no backstory. There is no circumstances. There's no future story. The universe itself is not trapped in any circumstances. This is what I'm saying. Not only people, worlds, universe, the universe is not trapped in any circumstance whatsoever. Ascension of the entire universe, the rapture of the universe. So we can rapture the universe, absolutely, by being willing to extend this recognition that there's absolutely nothing trapped in any circumstance whatsoever. This goes for trees, stones, dirt, sky, water. All appearances. There's absolutely no such situation as anything being trapped in any circumstance. There's no karma whatsoever. Okay. There's no destiny. There's no karma. There are no circumstances, actually. There's absolutely nothing that anyone needs to go through. Nothing whatsoever. It's not needed in the slightest bit. And then when you free the whole entire universe, then you're looking upon freedom. And you're aware of freedom and you see all as free. You're seeing all as free. And so you're happy. You're happy for everyone. You realize this is how you see them. You're not binding them at all. You're not requiring them to be trapped in some circumstances for any reason. So maybe this worked to silence the crusaders over there. They went quiet suddenly. So free all the crusaders from being stuck in any circumstance whatsoever. You see, free everyone. Because any circumstance that you see is spirit being stuck in, you are agreeing that you too are stuck in that circumstance. If we say that spirit inherently is stuck in this circumstance. Since we're spirit, that means we too are stuck in that circumstance. If we want to be free, free all from all circumstances, and saying there's no circumstance whatsoever that spirit can ever be stuck in the slightest bit. There's zero necessity for any backstory to truth, to God, to spirit, to light, to love. No backstory whatsoever to it. So, to experience your freedom, grant freedom to all. Because all is spirit. There's no necessity for any backstory. Nobody needs to suffer. Nobody needs to go through circumstances, actually, at all. It's useless. It has no merit whatsoever because we're already spirit. We're perfect. We're already, everything is already inherently great and released in the now. There's nothing that we need to be what we already are. So be willing to see all as free of any circumstances, either good or bad. Simply no circumstances whatsoever. It's very important. Don't weight or value some circumstance more than another. Say, well, I want them to all be free of sickness, but I don't want to be free of wellness. No, all circumstance. You don't want anyone to be bound by wellness either, or bound by, because you want them to be free. Freedom is totally beyond wellness. Our spirit is beyond anything we can call wellness. Wellness has to do with circumstance, like we have a good circumstance or something like that. So see, all is equal. All is equal. Equal vision is one way to put it. All is equal. All equally liberated from the necessity for any circumstance. Inherently so. This is the necessary focus at this time because the Crusaders are coming to your neighborhood, to your door for sure. They're going to turn things upside down here on this planet. It's not just a few people. The Crusader mentality has been cultivated in this world to an extraordinary extent. And what they say is, they're going to improve your circumstances according to what they see as improving your circumstances. But of course, our whole emphasis is on freedom from all circumstance, liberation from all circumstance, not to improve circumstance, liberation from all circumstance. Totally different. This is non-dual, whereas the Crusaders are extremely dualistic, and of course they always dress that up as, well, we're just here to improve circumstances. What they don't realize is, by insisting that everyone engage in a crusade to so-called improve circumstances, they're pulling the rug out from underneath the non-dual attention and practice that is necessary. Throwing the baby out with the bathwater. So no slaves, just everyone free of all circumstance, totally free of all necessity. We don't need to imagine a world. Imagine a whole universe completely free of all necessity, and even beyond a universe. So this is where we're going. This is where we're going with all this. Imagine the complete vanishment of all necessity, the complete vanishment of all being bound to any circumstance whatsoever. Now that doesn't mean the dance, the play of appearance doesn't stop. No, it still continues, can't continue on. But you realize that you're not bound by at all. Your spirit, all is spirit, untouched by this dream of necessity, this dream of circumstances, completely untouched by it, not pulled down in the slightest bit by it. So this is a very interesting video. We started in, the Crusaders came with their weed whackers and trying to improve circumstances, and we prevailed, and suddenly there's this great calm and peace and quiet. I don't know what happened. Maybe an exodus took place. Symbolically, so to speak. But when you're willing to free all from all backstory, you can leave a world like this, and it's okay. You're not concerned about that, because you've already released them. You've released the entire world. If you want to ascend, release the world from all necessity, all circumstances. Release everything in the world from any circumstance whatsoever. You're not demanding that it, you don't have a need for it to be bound by any circumstance at all. And with that attitude, you're going to leave the world with love and peace, and it's not going to bother you at all. You've already released everyone. So as far as you're concerned, they're with you always. You're not really leaving them at all. But you're sidestepping the great crusade that's going to take place here. To wipe out all the iniquities or whatever they think is the weeds need to be pulled. They're going to pull all the weeds, whack all the weeds. Of course, they'll define what are the weeds and what aren't. But you know, people have different ideas about what makes a beautiful garden. You never see two gardens that are exactly the same, do you? This one garden, a pepper garden, hot pepper garden. This guy. That was his love of his life. This is what he lived for. And it was like beautiful, beautiful, stunning, beautiful garden. But the fruits, you know, are like very, very hot. But, you know, that was his passion. Other people would say, no, we don't want any of these plants here. So that's not what we want. We want something different. So we have a very dualistic, crusader-based culture, world culture right now. And this is, you know, quite ruinous for the momentum of non-dual realization. And this is not new. I mean, I grew up in an intense crusader atmosphere in the 60s, the free speech movement, anti-authority movement, anti-war movement, civil rights movement. I mean, it was just off the charts, intense crusader mentality when I grew up. So it was very difficult to maintain spiritual non-dual focus. Very difficult. And these crusades have continued since then. You know, it really started in the 60s. It was radical, very radical. You combine all these various movements all together. You had the Black Power, Black Panther, Black Power movement, women's liberation movement, war, civil rights, free speech, all of this and more wrapped into just a boiling, you know, mass of activism. Of course, you had the architects of all this being older, very shrewd people, and then the younger people who easily steered into activism and crusades being used really in a lot of ways. for these objectives. Like nothing has changed. Nothing has changed. The architects of crusades always like to appeal to young liberal sort of people who say, hey, let's change the world, let's change the world. So it was very difficult. I couldn't stem the tide. I couldn't tell people, hey, it's better just to sit quietly. Nobody would listen. So then I tried to make beautiful music to turn people away from the crusading mentality. So I said, at least just sit here and listen to the music. And I tried that. It didn't work. And it's just some decided to sit quietly. Fortunately, we got some help from the East, the meditators of the East, saying, hey, you know, it's better just to sit quietly. Crusading mentality went to, like, for instance, in India, Sri Sri Anandamayi. Constantly people come to say, hey, you know, we have this great crusade, can you help us? And she said, it's very nice, but it's better just to sit quietly and just meditate. Sit quiet. Don't say anything. Don't do anything. Just be still. And they said, well, that's great, but we want to, you know, do this and liberate this. And you know, we have all these great goals to make humanity a better place. And India, you know, Bharat, the shining spiritual jewel of the world. She says, how can it be a shining jewel if the people are not sitting in silence? How can you be an example to the world if you're all activists? I said, well, we'll do that later. We'll do that later. First, we have to get all these. But what happens is activists, crusaders, they always say, oh, yeah, we'll get to that spiritual stuff later. But we have to change all the circumstances. But the entire goal of the spiritual path is to liberate all circumstances equally right now without changing a single one. This is the goal. So it's opposite of activism. So how can you get there through activism? This is what the bell needs to be ringing in your mind. Say, wait a minute. Can we really reach the goal of total non-activism, pure non-activism, everything released in the self, released in the now, as it is? Can we really reach that through being fanatical activists? I mean, is that something you want to accept as an equation of your life, the equation of your life? Because many, 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 many have accepted that is the equation of their life. And so something within you has to look at this and say, you know what? Am I going to accept that as the equation of my life or not? Now, I was just so sick, I couldn't be an activist. I think I was so conflicted. I didn't want to be in it. I got so sick, I couldn't participate in anything. I didn't participate in any of the activism of the 60s or the 70s. None of it. I was too ill. Too feeble. And so I just sat in a chair in my room reading spiritual books. But I felt terrible, you know, because I wasn't one with my generation, but we were, you know, I felt guilty, very guilty, very depressed. I thought it was very bad that I wasn't, you know, fixing the problems of the world. But lo and behold, now, decades later, here I am able to advise, at least pass on the advice of not how to fix the problems of the world, but how to release everything. Right now, all necessity for a circumstance, freedom, stand for true freedom. Able to, at least in some way, pass on and amplify that we're spirit and we're intrinsically free, and we can release this dream of circumstance right this instant without anything needing to happen at all. So, you know, that's real activism. That's the genuine activism. It's the perfect non-activism. It's the activism of perfect non-activism. And this isn't Mahatma Gandhi just having sit-ins in silence, because that's super activism, trying to generate massive changes in society. We're not trying to generate anything whatsoever. We're releasing, we're willing to release everything as it is into the perfection of the spontaneous self-sprung, now, matrix of pure spaciousness. Thank you, Longchenpa. Longchenpa is a resident expert, you know. Jesus is the chief honcho of the whole plan of salvation. Okay, at least that's how Jesus says, and I have no reason to say no, because he has a complete overview of everything. That's how I feel. Longchenpa is an expert in this fourth phase, apex Ati Yoga. So we're certainly very, very grateful for our resident experts here. But it never seems to work to come try to feel like, you know, who's who and who's what, because ultimately no one's bound by any circumstance whatsoever. We're completely free. I tend to feel a sense of struggle when I try to say, well, Jesus is this and Longchenpa is this, and that. And then, because to bring the egos in, okay, who's better, who's bigger, who's this, you know, who's that, like that. So maybe I better try not to do that, and intrinsically release all circumstances, even for Longchenpa, we release all circumstances, even for Jesus, we release Jesus from all circumstances. Jesus is not bound by any circumstance whatsoever, from our standpoint. Longchenpa is not bound by any circumstance. Jesus needs absolutely no backstory whatsoever. Longchenpa needs no backstory whatsoever. So from our standpoint, they're equally released. Okay, I think this is what we're getting at. From our standpoint, all stands equally released. No more and none less. There's zero need for any backstory to any to spirit whatsoever. None. Zero. There's no backstory on Jesus. There's no backstory on Longchenpa. There's no backstory on anyone. Even though we keep thinking there is, there isn't. It's already the fact. See, we're not establishing a fact. We're simply accepting the fact that already is the case. There is no backstory on anyone. Reality has no backstory to it. It's better just to stick with the overall abstraction of the whole thing, and I'm finding that when we get in abstract mode, it's better just to stay in abstract mode. Don't try to pull it down. I do that just to try and be more helpful, inclusive, those who have questions, struggling with that. But it's better not to do that, because that pulls you out of abstraction, actually. What we're going for is complete abstraction, total abstraction. There are not even any names for spirit. There's no backstory to spirit that requires a name. There's no circumstance that any spirit is bound to that suggests a name whatsoever. That's why they say God is totally nameless. And we are too, totally nameless. All is completely nameless. So in order to get the buzz, some people will feel left out. Say, I don't want to go into abstraction. Well, it's necessary, so you have to practice it. And when you feel struggling with it, just full stop in that. Don't struggle. Another crusader here. Everyone's got their skill saws, their power saws, you know. You're ready to cut through whatever they see they think needs to be cut. Of course, as you know, as far as building homes, everyone has a different idea of what a home's supposed to be. Everybody has a different idea. So crusaders have this false sense of oneness, because what they do is they all agree there's at least something that's got to be wrong. And so they have this idea that they're all in agreement with what should be right. And in fact, they all completely disagree with what is right. But for a while, they feel they're unifying with a common enemy. So this is an old tactic of duality that is still constantly being used. There's a common enemy. Make you think that you're really united when you're not. You don't feel true unity at all. Unity, real unity, is to accept that spirit has never been bound by any circumstance whatsoever. Has no name whatsoever. Has no label whatsoever. Has no story whatsoever. Has no word attached to it whatsoever. Here comes the crusade. Just listen. Release the crusaders from any necessity to be crusaders, by any and all circumstance. Now, when you release from all circumstance, that means nobody is bound to you. My circumstance, right? Now, of course, the Bay Area is ground zero for crusaders. And I'm aware of, you know, just there's so many, 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 many crusades here that they've fashioned and have, you know, are getting prepared to pursue. So many crusades. So when someone's all free of all bondage to any circumstance whatsoever, nobody is bound to debt to you, bound to do something for you, but you're not bound to them either. Nobody's bound to you. There's no... All our spirit, all our freedom. Crusaders, free. I wonder if Google will, analytics will catch this one and say copyright infringement, Crusader music. days anyway, isn't it? Maybe it will be copyright protected. Maybe Google say, oh yeah, this is, Joe and the Weed Whackers, you know, can't use this. Around a lot of Crusader music. Right? Make no mistake about that. Necessity, zero circumstance, zero past, zero story, zero time, zero space, zero process, zero form. This is true for all. This is true for all. The one family is still the perfect one family. Nothing has happened to it. No loss has ever happened to the one family that we all is. We are the one family. This is something that when it seeps into us, we get it. Oh, wow. That's it. We are it. We are it. We are it. Right now. All is it. Right now. There's no circumstance whatsoever that takes us an iota away from being it. No member of this one family has ever strayed one iota away from the perfect inclusiveness of this one family. Never, and never will. This is a fact. All hell's breaking loose around here right now, and yet we're in this beautifully secluded, lovely place here. It's peaceful and calm where I am. All around, all hell is breaking loose. Yes, but that's okay. It doesn't bother our focus at all, really. Going to the foothills. In the foothills, you can look down. You can see everything that's happening. The hustle and the bustle and the city and everything. All the crusades taking place. And yet, you're up above it a little bit. And you're just so peaceful and quiet up there. It's like that. It's like going to the foothills. You're not so far up that you're not completely out of contact. You know, you still see, just like this, we're just next door to the world, so to speak, and the crusades that are taking place. But, you know, we're not being touched by them at all. And yet we're not totally out of touch. We you know, hear that some frantic action's taking place. And okay, that's just the soundtrack. The soundtrack of the past story, the storyline. Soundtrack of a storyline. The backstory of how did I am become I am. I am doesn't need any such story. If we think if we don't supply the story, it will cease to be I am. That's not true. That's not true. We just tried to invent a backstory for it, as if we're the ones that caused it. You see, we want to be the causation of reality. Well, we're inventing this backstory, saying, well, this is how we caused reality. It's all a fantasy. It's all a dream. We're not bound by any circumstance whatsoever in this dream. Is the dreamer bound by the circumstance that in the dream? No. We're just pretending there's this backstory to reality so that we can feel like, yeah, we're the ones that are the architects of reality. Not true. Okay. Crusaders have moved on to other. But see, at the end of activism, activists will say, okay, now we've got the way we want. Alright, so now everything should be fine. And they haven't done anything towards realization at all. Maybe some of them will realize that and say, wow. I'm through with this activism. I'm through with it. And they will be. And they will be. And then, so then they start, you know, practicing sitting quietly. And gradually the truth dawns. Gradually it dawns. The dawn comes as quickly or as slowly as you need. So my case has been slow. It could be partially because of the times, the times here, living here, these times, super activist times. I mean, started in the 60s, never stopped. There's always some multiple villains that the Crusaders are out to absolutely crush. It's amazing. You see the intensity of it. And it with everyone, with social media, smartphones now, Twitter, whatever, you know, massive amount of crusading energy can be mobilized like that overnight. Something just blow up, some, you know, intense fury towards someone will blow up. in practicing this. Don't get lost in trying to be too overly specific. Try to remain as abstract as possible. I release everyone. Because you can always, if you try to work at it, you can always think of somebody. You think, you know what, they shouldn't be released from their circumstances. They're so terrible. You don't want to go out of your way to try to conjure up some image of something that you don't want to release. It's better to stay in the abstract. So crusaders are saying, yeah, I would release everyone except there are these people here that just can't. Once I get rid of them, then I'll do it. But that misses the entire point of the situation entirely. No one is bound by any circumstance. No one is bound by a backstory of what they are, of I am. So everyone is just working on this story. And intrinsically, no one is bound. Doesn't matter how evil or wicked. You know, there could be child abusing, dog abusing, swindlers, and mass murders, and all that stuff. That's just a backstory. Spirit is not bound by any of that. So facts don't change just because of the content of a backstory, content of a dream. You know, whether the content seems good or bad doesn't matter. It's still what we're saying, it's still a dream, 100%. What we are remains untouched. The one family is completely untouched because one family is completely free. One family is not bound by any circumstance. Nothing is bound by any circumstance. So how can there be guilt or sin actually, literally? You say these people are doing these terrible things. Well, who are they doing it to? is who they're doing it to, are they bound by circumstance? Well, if they're not bound by circumstance, what are they doing in that scene there? They're acting out a story of their own, aren't they? Oh, I was victimized. This is their backstory that they're working on, you know. They're free of all circumstance. They're free of all victimization, too. They're free of all necessity for any backstory whatsoever, too. Everybody is. We all are. All simultaneously, this instant. All is completely free of all backstory. Simultaneously, this instant. No, nothing has to be changed. No equations. No good has to be done, no bad has to be, you know, this instant, everything stands self-released without another instant passing whatsoever. So abstraction, 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 self-released in the now. Keep getting familiar with abstraction. Keep becoming more and more spiritually literate. This is essential. Keep being more and more comfortable with abstraction. And as your mind tries to pull you down, say, no, 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 don't struggle. Call that a struggle. Say, no need to struggle. Full stop in the now. Don't get pulled into the struggling about, well, what about, what about, what about, what about? That takes you out of abstraction. Now, as you start out on the path, you'll deal with specifics. But more and more it goes to more and more abstraction, more and more abstraction. Now, phase four, just say, don't struggle. Don't struggle. Stay in abstraction. Because that's the truth. Liberation is this instant for all. It's the only liberation there is this instant for all. This instant for all. This instant is for all. This instant is for all. This instant for all. This instant for all. This instant for all. This instant is for all. This instant for all. this instant for all. So, we have to get to that abstraction, this instant for all. That's it. Now, will we ever get to sit with somebody who's like that? I hope so. I hope so. There have been a few in the world like that, for sure. And people got to see them and sit with them, you know. So this instant for all, this instant for all. And just to feel that attitude, you know, just would permeate you. Yes. I look forward to that day, if it ever comes. That's the big wow that I'm trying to, you know, get to. That is someday, you know, meeting someone who has released, accepted this instant for all, and that's it, and is completely one with that. You know, it just zero continuity fear, and then you get to feel that attitude. You know, that's that presence, wow. And there also, I've seen an entire world realm, that actually has that presence, this instant for all. Called the death-free realms. And maybe it's the place that Jesus has made for us, actually. I was taken to a place in spirit. I felt it was perfect. No death, no sickness, nothing felt bound by circumstance there at all. Everything just was like freely present, perfectly freely present, of its own accord as an appearance. So it could be there's an entire place that gives us this vibe, instead of like just a guru here, the savior here. There might be an entire place that has this vibe to it. That's what I felt. I was just sitting there. All you want to do is just like sit and just feel it. Just say, wow, what is this place? Well, it's quite possible that's the place we're going to, if that happens. It may be that the crusaders being in control of this planet are so severe that it's better to go to a place. Instead of go to a teacher here in this world, go to a whole place, a whole world that has this vibe. This instant for all, this instant for all, this instant for all, this holy instant for all, this instant of holiness for all. This instant of oneness for all, this instant of self-releaseness for all, this instant of nowness for all, this instant of all-inclusiveness for all, this instant of intrinsic freedom from circumstance for all, this instant of zero necessity for all, this instant of zero necessity for all, this instant of zero necessity for all. Imagine a world, this is just a mantra, that this instant of zero necessity for all. And the mantra just continues ceaselessly. Imagine just dwelling into such a world, such a place. And we're not abandoning our crusader brothers and sisters. We're just making sure that when they cry out for help, we're able to show them the way. Maybe someday they'll want to sit with some guru, savior. You know, and you'll be the one they're sitting with. For sure. And they'll say, wow, this is a lot better than being a crusader. And then they'll have their gradual dawning, and you'll be able to reassure them. So this is how it could play out here. This instant for all. This instant for all. This self-sprung awareness for all. This self-sprung spontaneity for all. This self-sprung spontaneity for all. So keep the spiritual buzz going in your life right now. Keep it going. This is the crucial time. You hear these crusaders are ready to move. They've got the official okay, impromptu, the okay from all every nation in the world is agreeing. Yes, we need a global crusade. And the attitude now will resolve. This is very crucial time. Keep the spiritual buzz going, which is what I'm doing here, taping. Keep the spiritual buzz going in your life. Keep sitting quietly. Keep your attention on what gives you this truly spiritual buzz, raises you to abstraction, raises your attention to abstraction. This holy instant for all, this holy instant, this self-sprung, spontaneous awareness of the now matrix of pure spaciousness, of alpha clear light for all. This holy instant for all. This holy instant for all. Keep that buzz going. Keep that buzz going. Keep that buzz going. Very great. That's it for this one.